This vacation was more than just a trip. This brought me to some key places in my life and traced the beginning of a new life that began 15 years ago.
First stop of this adventure, Minnehaha Falls.
I've been visiting this waterfall since childhood. This waterfall was made famous by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow in his Song of Hiawatha. Here's an excerpt from his poem. Only once his pace he slackened, only once he paused and halted. Paused to purchase heads of arrows of the ancient arrow maker in the land of the Dakotas, where the falls of Minnehaha flash among the oak trees, laugh and leap into the valley.
Here I am in Minneapolis, Minnesota, at Crystal Lake Cemetery. My grandmother was buried here in April of 2006. This is her gravestone. My grandfather, who died in 1950, is buried right next to her. And over here, 1951, my mom lost her brother.
And Menominee, Wisconsin is the place where it all began.
The University of Wisconsin Stout campus. I spent 5 good years of my life at this place. 2 of those years as part of Chi Alpha campus ministry.
In 1992, I stayed in this dormitory, attended classes, and walked the many campus sidewalks. That was a fall full of moral conflict. On November 4th, I turned 21, and a few days later there came a point of decision.
I'm sitting here at the very spot where on November 9th, 1992, my life was surrendered to Jesus Christ. I was walking on my way to class, convicted of sin, heading that direction to the art building.
Church once known as Christian Life Ministries. I didn't attend here right away, but within 6 months of saying the prayer of salvation, I was hungry for the gifts of the Holy Spirit. On April 25th, 1993, I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues. That church may no longer be here, but its legacy lives on.
On May 14th, 1993, I was baptized here in the Chippewa River, the Dunville Bottom, south of Menominee, Wisconsin. I was baptized with a group of college students from Chi Alpha Campus Ministries at the University